What's up everybody, my name is Karan and welcome back to my channel again. My channel name is Tapri. Hope everyone is fit, fine and take care of themselves. So guys, in this video we'll be discussing the new brochure which is released on 21st of July this week itself. So we have a lot of parents and the students who are requesting that what are the big difference in this week in there. So we'll be having a discussion in there itself. So at the left, I'll try to show each and everything to you. If you want to join our individual mentorship program, that also you can do. We kept a very nominal charges for that. So let's get started. So in here, you can see that this is the Dasa brochure, which is recently released. So if you see in here, there it's very much similar. The days and everything is very much similar. There are a lot of parents who are confused, like regarding the CSAB and Dasa. See, they had clearly mentioned in here, if you see document uploading for Dasa, and the date is this. So it's very clear, very clear. A request, please go through the brochure, right? They had mentioned 30th July is the date. 30th July 30 is the date when the registration for Dasa will be started. So they had clearly mentioned, so there is no confusion about it. We had already made a detailed video regarding this, like what are the process and how you will be going along it. After this, if you see, display of the mock seat allocation based on the choice filled in by candidate. So as per the mock, like while you will be doing the process, first you have to upload the documents, then documents will be verified, then you have to pay the payment. Once you're done with the payment, then you will be filling the choice filling. So it will be going like this. At the end, you can take the printout of your choice filling. After that, there will be a mock allotment display, which will be happening on 3rd of August. Okay, if you come a little bit down, now once the mock allotment is done, then what will be happening after that mock allotment, you can rearrange your choice filling, and after the rearrangement, the first round of the allotment will be happening on 9th of August. On 9th of August, the first round of allotment will be done. Okay, so as per that itself, you will be having a picture, you will be having a clarity idea like what exactly we are getting. If you have not made your choice filling yet, you should start it. You should make a choice filling of yours. If you have not make your documents ready, please make your documents ready. It's very important because anyhow now we don't have much time left. So this is also done. If you go a little bit more down now, then there will be option of freeze, slide, float, surrender, withdraw. Already we had explained in the previous video, you can watch it. Now you come round two. Okay, so the round two allotment will be 14th of August. See, the thing is, we have to only follow the Dasa. Okay, wherever the Dasa is mentioned, you have to follow that date only. CSAB is something different, which we have already explained in the previous videos. So now the second allotment is on 14th of August, and likewise the third allotment is will be happening on 19th of August. So these are the things which they had mentioned, you know, in this brochure. These are the documents. Agreement of participating in Dasa. Those kids who are, you know, participating in Dasa and CSAB both, they have to submit this. List of the documents to be uploaded by the candidate. They had clearly mentioned what are the documents they will be requiring. You can just go through it. Already we had discussed so many times. This is very important. If any of the document is not in the language, in the Hindi or English, you have to translate it. Okay, so translation copy should be required, and that should be done from the authorized, you know, translation authority. That you have to do. Original documents will be produced at the time of, you know, whenever you are going to the college or reporting to the college, at the time you have to you know, present our original documents. So authentication of citizen card of Nepal. So this you can have a look, although it's not, you know, that very complex. So very easy. Okay, so these are the very, so I don't think so they had made something very complex. This is a very much similar to the previous document only. Yeah, so this is very much similar. Medical certificate is there, you have to go through it. 11th and 12th complete, that you had completed 11th and 12th. For the CIWG candidate, this is very important. Already discussed in the previous video. certificate of the school proof, so letterhead, you should be getting it. And undertaking, if any of the students, okay, this I want to explain. If any of the students, they are getting less marks in the grade 12th, so what they can do, they have to present the certificate. They have to, you know, give the undertaking certificate that once you'll be getting the results, they'll be uploading this certificate. So this is very much similar with the previous document, not big changes in here anywhere. Few things that they had make it very clear that if your documents are not uploaded properly, then your CIWG category status will be, you know, revoked and you will be lying under the non-CIWG category. That they had clearly mentioned. So the document should be very clear. If you want us to verify your document also, you can ping us. We will be helping from our end itself. And please get all the documents from your school and whatever the documents they had mentioned, please make that document in that particular format. Although there are a lot of parents who are telling from the company they are not getting this, in that particular format, that is fine. That's we can understand, that they can understand that, okay, the company, whatever the format is there, that only they can produce. But the rest of the other documents should be very clear. Even if your father, you know, letter is in some other language, you have to translate it with the local, you know, whatever the authorized translation. Through them they can translate it, and you can, while uploading, you can upload that copy as well. So these are the important things which I want to discuss in this video. A part of this, I don't think so there's any big changes in there. If you have any queries, you can let us know. By the time, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat, and as always, God bless you all.